Pisces, this is your forecast for the month of July 2018. This is a general reading for Pisces Sun, Pisces Rising, or Pisces Moon. For a more rounded overview, please watch your rising and moon sign as well. Now, the last card is a major card, which says that there are spiritual lessons attached to your circumstances, and so things are largely out of your control. For some of you, this is going to represent a Capricorn. For others of you, this may manifest as an ex or a parent, an older person, an authority figure, you having to act as an authority. It's likely that you're dealing with some kind of challenge or responsibility or extra burden or some time delays or simply a bad attitude. For some of you, this is about a business contract. You may have to turn your back on it. Maybe, you know, Or you lost business, you lost, you know, an agreement, or it could be that, you know, this is all about sexuality and you're having to make a decision about whether you want to become intimately connected to another person. For some of you, maybe this is a chronic illness that you're having to deal with and you don't really know what to do. You're trying to get more information about that. Whatever it is, your survival instincts, your urges, your intuition, your determination is very strong. And you may be sitting on the fence deciding which way to go. Should I do the right thing or should I do the wrong thing? Should I take a risk or should I go with what's safe? And it's possible that, you know, you've got this tremendous influence where you can make somebody go either way. You can play mind games this week and you can make people think things and do things. You are the puppet master. The only issue is you may be selling yourself some propaganda as well. So you have to make sure that you maintain your sense of integrity. This is a week where it's very easy for you to give over to some form of temptation. Regardless of how petty or small it may be, your emotions, your material concerns are all tied together in one big ball. And, you know, for some of you, this is going to be a week where if you had a dilemma, you were struggling with something, some kind of loss, you're going to have an aha moment. You're going to get a couple of strokes of good luck. You're going to have some brilliant ideas. You're going to come up with a solution that saves your hide, and it's going to help you right at the very last moment. It's going to save the day. Now, for others of you, you may be pushing your luck. If you have done something where you were taking a gamble, maybe there's a loss, or you got involved in a love affair that had some risk to it, it may catch up to you. Or you were taking too much for granted with your health, you may have to deal with the consequences of that. Whatever it is, you're having to pay the piper. This is a week of using your common sense, knowing what your limitations are, what you're capable of, what you can give in a partnership, what's too much, whether it's equal. Those are important considerations because you may be very enthusiastic about something and maybe you're biting off more than you can chew. Maybe you think you can do it all, be all, overcome some impossible challenge, when obviously that's not the case. And this may be strongly motivated by your desire to gain some recognition, some success, some authority. Also, you know, because that's your goal and you're very intuitive this week, you may know just who to connect to and when in order to win the game, to further your influence. You can look at other people and see what their merit is, what their intentions are, what their motivation, and that may help you make a decision about whether you should turn your back on something or not. But this is a week where you can lose because you were putting something off. You were procrastinating something that you needed to deal with. And maybe you were taking an exceptionally foolish risk with regard to something. You're taking a chance. Or again, you're striking out and behaving in ways that are devious or that create more harm than good. And this may have been because you wanted that recognition. At the root of it was you wanted to be desired or loved. You may even have wanted to offer your help, your services, but maybe you overextend yourself in some way, or maybe you have to balance that against the fear of your pessimism. It could be the doubt in your capabilities, the faith in yourself, or it could be that you don't want to connect in ways where people expect too much. Maybe there's going to be too many demands, too many responsibilities. Do I want that or do I not? It could be in some cases you are tempted to go beyond your limit. You are trying to do things that you can't possibly accomplish, maybe because of time constraints or health concerns or financial issues. One thing is for certain, what is important is that you are aware of your standard of ethics and that you maintain that. This could be a week where selfishness, greed, pessimism, negativity is at play, either on the part of self or others. Maybe you're involved in an unhealthy attachment. Maybe somebody's greedy or needy or destructive. Maybe you're involved in an abusive situation and you need to turn your back on that. It could be somebody's being manipulative or, there are just some fears that need to be confronted and faced. This is a week where you're dealing with the shadow of yourself or a situation. You may be taking unnecessary risk. There could be some hidden aspects of yourself or a situation, or simply some fears, some illusions, some irrational thoughts, and you need to acknowledge those fears. Whatever it is, this is a habit or a chronic condition or a pattern that may be self-perpetuating it. You may be driving this chronic behavior. In some cases, you may turn your back on a partnership or a situation because you've decided you need more alone time. You are imposing limitations on yourself because you've got to take care of you. In other cases, this is pure selfishness. Or you're having to make an unhappy choice and you don't know whether you should do that. You need to leave a negative or bad or confining situation or relationship and you're having to muster the courage to do that. It could be that you're getting some medical help. There could be issues of alcoholism, addiction. Maybe there's compulsiveness or an obsession with power, sex, money, drugs, some kind of instinct. For others of you, you're turning your back on sexuality and intimacy because you have some hang-ups or some fears. Or, that's all you can focus on are these powerful urges that you are tempted to give into. So this is a week about looking at power, releasing yourself from some kind of bondage or where perhaps you've been excessively ambitious or selfish, or on the other hand, there's indecision and fear and dependency. Maybe you're in a smothering relationship, or somebody's using the other person for selfish ends or material gains. So again, this may come through a parent or parental concerns, older people, authority figures, exes, anything that creates some kind of responsibility or obligation or burden and limits you in some way. And again, it's likely that whatever you're doing, there's a time challenge to it.